suspected synthetic drug ring busted in Marion. Those drugs were coming from overseas and were being sold right here in central Indiana. Thanks for joining us tonight live at 5. I'm Dan Spieler.
And I'm Fanchen Stinger. Fox 59's Alexis McAdams shows us where the drugs were actually coming from.
Investigators tell me those drugs were delivered from China in an envelope. Inside, enough dangerous powder to make hundreds of pounds of synthetic drugs.
A tip from U.S. Customs and Border Patrol leads to this package full of a yellow powdery synthetic drug from China.
This is specifically a synthetic cannabinoid, so it mimics the effects of THC on the body.
And to the arrests of more than half a dozen people, now suspected of being part of a large synthetic drug trafficking ring in Grant County.
These were continual shipments, so it's not like they just started.
The Joint Enforcement Against Narcotics Team, or the GENE Team, in Marion says the drugs were shipped to this Grant County home on Wednesday.
It was going to be sprayed onto some sort of a plant-like material. The amount of the drugs that came in would produce several hundred pounds of finished product.
Within just 5 minutes, investigators say these suspects had the spice and baggies ready to distribute.
We want to make sure they didn't get into the community, so that was our biggest fear. We wanted to make sure that package was controlled and we didn't let it get out of our sight.
Undercover investigators with the GENE Team tell me Joseph Butler was the main target of the investigation. Detectives say Butler used his 8-year-old son's name to order those drugs from China, but federal authorities still flagged the package.
The synthetics that are being made and brought in from China have gotten worse.
Recently, the GENE Team says they've seen more overdoses linked to spice in Grant County.
We've seen lately individuals that are so out of their mind that they jump onto a car hood and pull the windshield wipers off of the cars. We actually had a whole family passed out in a vehicle.
These arrests are just a glimpse at the dent the teams put in the county's drug trade and the promise they make to keep going until more suspected dealers are behind bars.
The issue of spice and other synthetic drugs has been going on for several years now, and the community has wanted something done about it for a while.
Tonight, detectives tell me more arrests and more charges could be coming in this case as they continue to monitor for more shipments. In Marion, I'm Alexis McAdams. Back to you.
Alexis, thank you. You saw the sunshine there.